Consider a test scenario to check login functionality. There are many possible variations to check this scenario. Check response on entering a valid agent name and password. Check response on entering an invalid agent name and password. Check response when the agent name is empty and the login button is pressed. And many more. This is nothing but a test case. Test scenarios are rather vague and cover a wide range of possibilities. Testing is all about being very specific, hence we need test cases. Now just consider the test case, check response on entering a valid agent name and password. It's obvious that this test case needs input values, agent name and password. This is nothing but test data. Identifying test data can be time-consuming and may sometimes require creating test data afresh. For that reason, it needs to be documented. Before we proceed, consider a quote from a witty man. To ensure perfect aim, shoot first and call whatever you hit the target. But if you do not live by this philosophy, which I am sure most of you do not, then your test case must have an expected result. For our test case, the expected result would be login should be successful. If expected results are not documented, we may miss out on small differences in calculations in results, which otherwise look okay. Consider this example, where you are calculating monthly pay for an employee, which involves lots of calculations. The need for documenting expected results becomes obvious. Suppose the author of the test case has left the organization, is on vacation, is sick and off duty, or is just very busy with other critical tasks, and you are recently hired and have been asked to execute the test case. Since you are new, it would certainly help to have test steps documented, which in this case would be launch the application, enter an agent name, enter a password, and click OK. You may think that for these simple test steps, documentation is not required, but what if your test steps look something like this? I think the need will become immediately obvious. That apart, your test case may have fields like a precondition, which specifies things which must be in place before the test can run. For our test case, a precondition would be flight reservation application should be installed. Also, your test case may include a postcondition, which specifies anything that applies after the test case completes. For our test case, a postcondition would be time and date of login is stored in the database. During test case execution, you will document the results observed in the actual results column and may even attach some screenshots. Based on comparison of actual and expected results, assign pass and fail status. This entire table may be created in Word, Excel, or any other test management tool. That's all to test case design. Below, you will find links to download a sample test case specification template.